At least two high school parties lead to Summit's biggest outbreak of COVID-19. Phil Lindemann, Krystal, 93 News. First, Public Health Director Amy Wineland came on the Krystal 93 morning show today, where she had just one message: treat COVID-19 like wildfire.
We throw every resource at a wildfire to protect people's homes, and this needs to be in that manner. We need to think about this as a wildfire. We are the firefighters trying to put water on this fire right now, and we need everyone to participate in this.
Now, unlike fire, COVID might be invisible, but the impact on health and state mandates is not.
Yes, it might not be a severe illness for some, but that still counts against us. It'll count against our economy. Unfortunately, it might mean people will lose their jobs, and it will impact our ski season and our ability to have what we all need and want to have happen.
Joining Wineland was Sheriff Jaime FitzSimons reviewing new, stricter enforcement for public health order violations.
We've done the nice educational approach. Our numbers are on the rise. We're going to start to go after some of these more egregious violators. I mean, we're looking at now COVID parties that are being held. Yeah. We're looking at after-hour activities and gatherings that are going on. I mean, like purposely, like turning their nose up to what's going on here in the community.
The latest local health order limits gatherings to 6 people inside and 10 people outside from no more than 2 households each. Fines will top out at $5,000 per violation. Students at Summit High School are learning from home this week following the largest local outbreak since the onset of the virus. At least 22 students have come down with COVID after a pair of youth parties earlier this month. Several got sick the weekend of October 10th. 9 got sick at a bigger party the following weekend. School officials hope students can return to classrooms by November 9th. There is another smaller outbreak, 2 cases at Advanced Dermatology in Frisco. Investigation shows management there did not enforce quarantine for 2 asymptomatic employees. Summit confirms 719 total cases of COVID countywide as of today. We've been hearing how surging caseload could threaten ski season. So, how does Summit compare to other resort counties? A graph from the Insights Collective shows the worst is Flathead County, Montana, home to whitefish, peaking at nearly 100 new cases in 1 week earlier this month. By this week, Flathead is down to 70 per week. Summit is next behind Flathead at 45 new cases weekly, followed by Summit County, Utah, and Park City at 40, Blaine County, Idaho, and Sun Valley at 35, and Teton County, Wyoming, home to Jackson Hole and Grand Targhee, at 32. Eagle and Pitkin counties are just about even at 16 to 18 new cases weekly. 2 snowboarders charged with tripping an avalanche above the Eisenhower Tunnel this March are going to trial. Evan Hannibal and Tyler DeWitt are due in court next March, nearly 1 year after the incident when they allegedly set off a slide that destroyed a mitigation device and buried a service road. No one was injured, and the two reported the slide immediately. They face criminal charges and $168,000 in fines, the first and harshest penalty of its kind in Colorado. A reminder that CDOT is closing Highway 91 from Copper to Leadville tonight to install a pedestrian bridge. Closure runs from 7 p.m. to 5 a.m. Your detour from Leadville is US 24 through Minturn to I-70. Again, Highway 91 is closed starting 7 o'clock tonight. The latest now on coronavirus and virtual venom. In April and May, County Commissioner Elizabeth Lawrence was giving regular COVID updates on Facebook until she just couldn't anymore.
You know, I quit doing the video updates because I simply couldn't handle the hate mail. It was too hard. You know, I had to work and take care of our community and also be a mom and support my family during this time.
She admits online hate comes with the territory, but for other people in other jobs, it should not.
That's just not for our elected official, but that's for our frontline workers. Those people that are servers at a restaurant that are asking you to wear a mask. Those people that work the front of a grocery store that, again, are asking you to wait in line.
Summit County's latest infection rate is 539 per 100,000 people, the highest ever, with a positive test rate of 10.8%, now officially considered high risk. Summit Medical Center is at 29% capacity, up 8 points from yesterday. The hospital has never been more than 59% full. And in local sports, brought to you by American Family Insurance, the WEIS agency, chances are good Summit High School football will not finish the season. The entire high school went to online learning Tuesday, and practice was put on hold for 2 more weeks, overriding a team quarantine that started last week. Coaches were hoping to get 4 days of practice next week for a November 6th game with Battle Mountain, but that is all now in limbo. Phil Lindemann, Krystal 93 News.